So a lot of my ships are here in system. I've got my mining ships here and some other ships I've been playing around with. I've been using some things to try new fits and stuff. I tried a Caracal out for a little bit of PvE. I may be able to make this work. It's a bit wonky though. Right now I'm using heavy assault missile launchers on it. And I'm having a bit of trouble with this, but I think I may be able to find a way to make something work now that I've got access to some Tech 2 stuff. I did just train up, let's see here, shield, tactical shield manip to, no, wait, shield upgrades to level 4. So now I've got access to some level 2, Tech 2 rechargers, resistance amps, and extenders, which will be pretty helpful out here, especially for my passive tank, Drake. But I have a couple of other ships that are decent for speed tanking and other things. They can't take down any of the big rats, but they're decent at taking down the smaller ones. Now, when it comes to making a living out here, though, I'm not going to be able to do that much from killing rats the way that other people clear belts and things, because my ships just aren't strong enough. I don't have enough skills in those areas. So we'll have to find another way to make money, and my way for doing that is going to be through production and mining the way it was in HiSec. It's just going to be a little bit more difficult now. I'm going to need to rely on my corporation a lot more than I used to. And I'm going to need to use something else that I had hoped I would not have to. I'm going to have to create an alt character. I've already created a couple of characters that I've just used for basic scouting and such. But I'm going to have to train one a little bit. I could get away with it doing it for free, but what I'm going to end up doing is going to be a much longer and more involved process that'll allow me to do a basic logistics structure here in Nullsec that most people probably already have down pat. I can't just take my main character and load it up with a freighter and fly it out into HiSec and go all the way to wherever to trade because of all the war decks that are on us right now. So HiSec is off limit for my main character because I've been so offensive as to have joined a corporation. Now, I can always use one of my alts, who does not need to join a corporation, and is therefore immune to war declarations. Not immune to being killed, depending on what he's transporting, people will still suicide gank it. But, should be immune to standard war decks. Now, I won't be showing those characters on here, because I don't want people to put a bunch of bounties on them at random, as you do. So I'll try to keep them secret. But my plan is to do this. I'm planning on mining in these areas around here, hopefully with corporation mining. And what I'll do is I'll take that ore, and I will transport it on this character in a Miasmos or something, out to the edges of HiSec, somewhere around here. And then I will switch characters onto an alternate character who is going to be trained in basic industrial piloting and possibly eventually even freighting, depending on whether or not I want to use any plexes or something like that. But that's going to be a whole lot. I mean, just getting the skill books to fly a freighter is 130 mil. You're looking at 2 billion or so to, or no, about 1.5 billion to buy a freighter, and then around a month to fly it at all, and then another month to fly it well. And that's something that I'm not willing to put my main character's training skill on hold for a month, let alone 2 months. So something that I'd be more likely to do with training two characters at the same time. Some people have signed up through my link. I put it on one of my videos. I can't remember which one. I might have one on the main video, the first one in the playlist. And have upgraded their accounts. So I was able to get some plexes through that. I saved a couple of them for the possibility of training, and I sold one and put it into our alliances, or our corporation's fund. My money is much the same as it was. Our corporation's got a lot of money now. I probably shouldn't be showing that. Sorry, Ark. My money is similar to what it was. I lost about 130 million ISK in the move because our POS structure was in Senka, and it had all of my minerals and production jobs in it, and we had to cancel those, and I had about 130 million in materials in them at the time. So that was a big loss for me. So now I'm floating at around 300 million in the wallet. So we really need to start putting our hammer to the grindstone and making some money. So yeah, it comes down to the logistics side of things. Being able to get ore is not a big deal. Being able to get valuable ore is also not a big deal. We'll also be able to compress that ore, and then I can ship, hopefully, great quantities of it out to a high-sec area, and then hop it onto an immune-to-war-deck alt, and move that around and do purchasing and buying and selling and trading on that character. So that's the plan for now. Actually doing it is going to be a whole different thing, and I'm going to have to get my miner unpacked and set up and start doing that, but I think we've got... There's been an Imperial Navy slicer running around here recently causing trouble, so I may want to wait on that. But for now, that's our plan for finding our niche here in high-sec. We've also got to deal with research. I haven't got any of that stuff taken care of. I have my cargo container full of blueprints right now, but I had to cancel all my research jobs. However, out here, we have really nice production and research facilities. This one here that I may be using for production has got a really nice manufacturing facility with bonuses to different types of supports. This one's got, I don't know what the fuck this even means, this little plus sign here. Maybe it's good, maybe it's not, who fucking knows? I don't know. But there's no research facilities here. The one that we'll use for research will probably be this one, which has got a number of different research capabilities, everything from reverse engineering, invention, copying, time and material efficiency. And you look, see, these are 30% bonuses to facilities, not even POSs, just facilities. And so does their production facilities. Like if I go here to one of my blueprints and I look at just say, what's one of my research? Here we go. We've got a researched hobgoblin blueprint here. Come on. That one. So for this one, you'll see it's got a built-in extra... the blueprint efficiency is the same here, but it should have a, 20% or extra blueprint from... No, I guess that's just... Maybe this facility doesn't have... Oh, no, I'm looking at the other one. The wrong facility. I'm looking at the BXJ one. I think our production facility would be A-OK. And this one has... Yes, facility 30% there. And then it has an extra... No, that one doesn't have any extra material efficiency to drones, at least. Some of them do. Maybe it's the Sanchez one? No, I guess not. Some of them have material efficiency bonuses as well. This one does not have the time efficiency. But I'm going to have to learn the different areas where it's good to build things and whatnot by going through this process of checking to see if there's any efficiency bonuses. But for now, my plan is to find areas around here in our sovereign space to start production and building of materials, hopefully at a much reduced cost than what we would normally have to do in high-sec, and then I'll be able to transport them through my logistics system back into high-sec, make some money, and transport minerals back in here to either make more production or to sell. The other alternative would be to do reprocessing here. We'll have some better reprocessing facilities, and it will be available to me to do that. But I think I might want to keep it simple and just sell the ore and buy the minerals, just so that there's no complicated losses in the process of weird mathematics. But that's the plan for now. Find a niche in the production and research facility here. Do some mining, try not to get stepped on by giants moving massive fleets around, and make a little money. Here we go. This looks like the place to do a lot of production. The 30KDA one has material consumption and job duration bonuses to damn near everything, which is a big deal when you can get your material cost down by 13% and then your time cost down by another 30%. That makes production very, very viable and profitable out here. The only difference is that this station has a small tax associated with it. I believe... Let me see here. We need to find... MY has a production facility as well. Do they have the same upgrades? I think so. Probably similar. Yeah. So there's options for where we can do these things. Some of them are further away than others. I don't think AOK has the... Yeah, no, AOK has just got the basic facility job duration modifier, but there are other systems nearby we can use for other different jobs and whatnot. And then if you want to get really specific with your research and stuff, I think there's some that have better benefits to other things. But AOK looks like where we would probably end up be doing our... Not AOK. Probably be at this one, even though it has a 4% tax associated with it, just because of the insane amounts of bonuses it gets to production. As far as research, I don't think it has any benefit, so we'd probably be better off doing something like these ones here. 30% off. Not a bad deal. Just comes down to finding one close by that we can get into our logistics chain. One of our guys is being engaged right now, so I'm trying to get to him in time to try to scram the guy fighting him. He's being attacked by the guy I mentioned earlier, the dude with the Imperial Navy slicer. So hopefully I can get up on him. Where is he? I don't see him. Where's he at? Did he leave?
He just warped in and shot me. The AI was just like, warp, and then shot.
Damn it.
I need to see. He's dead anymore.
Alright, I'll go take a look and see if I can find him somewhere else.
He's probably at the E1 gate.
Oh, which the second he warped in.
Sorry if the volume levels are fucked. Haven't had time to check him yet. There he is. He's targeting me right now. He's scramming me, I'm scramming him.
Where is he?
I'm going down. Oh, damage control. Get him! He's scrammed! No, he's not. Alright.
Oi, where is he at?
He got me. Just go get him. He's still there.
Where's he at?
He's right there. He's shooting at you.
Oh, shit.
Yeah. I couldn't get up on him fast enough to scram him. He warped in at a really weird spot. I'll go grab another one and come right back, alright? Probably at... Did you see where he warped? What, like, general direction he warped to?
He warped... Oh, shit. I don't know if he warped off in the direction of the station, but it's all...
He's round back. Two, fight! Trying to find him. He's still in system.
Just wait for him to warp off, because he's gonna warp off. We know that.
He's red boxing me.
He's there with you again?
Yep, he's here with
we
me
got
again.
More loot.
Alright, I'm waiting at E1.
We got more news. I'm bailing.
He's brought help.
Okay, I'm going to you then.
Oh, he's brought...
Lots of nukes.
Oh,
shit.
That's what I was worried about with that guy.
Yeah.
There's no way he would do this unless he has friends. Can you get out?
Yeah, he warped out. I'm warping out as well.
Get back to the station. He probably thinks you're going to stay there because you did that for so long, but that's a lot of nukes. So, two station.
Yeah.
Station safe.
Everyone dock.
Docking
request accepted. You guys, any of you guys still in warp? Because if so, drop me a safe spot in the warp machines.
No, I'm over at gun station.
Yeah, I'm in. Well, that was scary. Well, we weren't able to catch that guy, and he warped a whole bunch of his buddies in. We lost a Vexor Navy issue, but everybody else managed to get out okay. We probably should not have tried to engage, just because that's just sort of a bad idea. But it's in the nature of funsies, so... I tried to get on him and scram him so my guys could get there, but I don't have the kind of technology available to allow me to hold someone without immediately dying. Once he targeted me, I was basically dead, because those Tech 2 ships just rip through... little tech onesies that we have. But at least we're willing to go out and give it a shot. Back to work. As you probably saw by that encounter, I'm horrible at PvP. I wasn't able to get in range to scramble him. I never turned my damage control on. I don't even know if I had it fucking targeted. But we're gonna have to learn out here. And in the future, we probably should have just left. That would be the thing to do, but... That's not really my attitude. If somebody's out here, you know, trying to cause shit, we'll do our best to try to field something, even if we are just flying a bunch of junk. But that Condor loss was not a big deal. It didn't really even have much on it. And I think it was even insured. Sorry, nullsec. I know I'm breaking the rules, but I do occasionally insure my ships. Anyway, I'm going to get ready to do some mining now that we've chased them off. Yes, that's what we did. Well, just sitting out here in the belt. Arknor. That's the good stuff right there. I don't know what kind of quantities we're talking about, but there's also ochre and get off there. Oh, what's that little guy? Ooh, crimson Arknor and some hemophorite. I don't know if the crimson Arknor is any good or not. I think I'm going to stick to the unspecial stuff because I'm not planning on processing this stuff. But if I was, ooh, and Spider-Man, Macklemore, please. Anyway, we've got ourselves a little belt. We can do some mining in here. That's the stuff right there. Not a lot of quantity. Spider-Man doesn't have a lot either. But we've also got Crimson Arknor, Omber, and Ochre. Now, this stuff would be great for production, because these are some expensive bits in here. If we could get those reprocessed at full capabilities. But I think we're going to be mining these mostly for our personal resources. Ooh, Prime Arknor. Yeah, this is, I believe, the King of Ore. With a shitload of Megasite, Zidrine, and Mexalon. The King of All Ores. Let me see if I can get a better scan now. Oh yeah. It's much, much special things. Jaspit, Hedbergite, Hemophorite, Omber, Arknor, Ochre, Scordite, Gneiss. Wow, just whatever. You name it, it's here. So there's that. That's a good thing. That's a nice reason to live here. If you can survive it. Now, if any NPC rats do spawn here, they will probably be of the battleship variety. They will be much more difficult to avoid than any normal gankers would be, so much the same level of danger. And for this, I'm just going to keep this open hereabouts, make sure no neutrals come in system, and if they do, I will immediately get the fuck out. Problem is, I'm using a retriever, which is not the best for surviving stuff. So I'm going to need to make sure that I am oriented exactly and aligned exactly to our station of destination if I want any chance at all of getting out of here alive, and I'm just going to leave that on full time. So we're in the danger zone now, but we're mining the good shit. Now we're talking. Prime Arknor is the rarest of the rare. The King of Ores! 10% greater mineral yield than regular Ark. The stuff that makes billionaires out of people lucky enough to stumble upon a vein. The rarest and most sought after ore in the known universe. Oh, I'm getting nuggets. I'm getting nuggets. Ha! I just went and got a cup of coffee. In nullsec. While mining AFK. See, that's what you gotta do. Sometimes the universe will crush you under its boot and defeat you. But you just gotta make sure that when it's not busily crushing you, you take advantage, and you say, fuck you, universe, I'll do what I want. And it's going to crush you for that, but you just got to get back up and do it again. Keep on digging. So I've gone over a lot of the negatives of nullsec, but there are the occasional positives, like this. Oh, you lovely bastards. That's beautiful. It's so pretty. I want one. Can I keep it? I want to look at it. Welcome into the head. Oh. Gorgeous. Now we get to the fun logistics of doing stuff in nullsec. We've got to move some blueprints over to a nearby system. 3GD6. and get them researched there, because each one of these will have a 30% bonus to the time involved in researching them, and that's significant. Like this Condor blueprint, that's minus 2 weeks off of the research time. It's still going to be a month to do, but, you know, get it started now before it's too late. Now, the problem with this is that this is going to be a bitch to do and survive, because we go through E1, no problem, Mux, no problem, AX TAC, no problem, GE TAC, problem, YHN, huge problem, and then that one's pretty bad too. Our intel is always screaming about YH and VTAC 3, and YH is right where I have to go, so if I'm gonna die, that's where it's gonna be. So I'm keeping this trip to a minimum. I've got a freighter loaded up with stuff I'm gonna move out to HiSec, but for now I'm gonna get these moved first. I'm gonna move two shipments by shuttle, one set of blueprints over to the research area, and then another set of blueprints over to the manufacturing area, and then I'll deal with the logistics of getting minerals and shit and transporting stuff out of here. But for now, we're just gonna have to fly fast and fly crazy and try to get through all the blockades if there are any. Fortunately, you know, I mean, it's... I guess the whole core idea here is loss minimalization. Avoiding critical losses. And so losing these four blueprints here is not going to end me. The only one that's even got any research time on it is this tractor beam. It's got 10% ME done. And these two, the light missile launcher and the rocket launcher, are kind of useless, except for the scenario if I go into invention and I get some Tech 2 blueprints out of them. So, not putting all my eggs in one basket and being prepared for the loss. The issue is mostly going to be when I have to go and do mineral transports through here. It's going to be a real bitch, so I'm going to have to keep my eye well open for that part. But for now, I'll just be scooting around in my shuttle, trying to avoid all the nasty pirates. I must be very fucking confused, but for some reason I thought we were going through YH, but it appears we're not. I don't know why I thought that. Where's YH? There's VY. There's 3TAC. Is this YH? Yeah. Okay, I guess it's just an alternative route. For some reason, this one's shorter. Well, I've gone through 3TAC out quite a lot, and that's never been a problem. Well, I mean, it has been a problem, actually. That's where I got killed last time. But I don't think I'll be doing a direct jump through GE to the 3TAC gate. So I don't know why it initially did that and then changed its mind partway through. Do I have some sort of weird route settings? I don't know. I could turn off avoid low-sec systems and see if it gives me a crazy route. But I think we're good. Yeah, it's 33 days here at Sanchez Major Base of Operations, and if I were to do it in GE where there's no upgrades, it's 47 days. So, huge benefit. Small tax, but damn well worth it. So I'm going to start all these little buddies up here on recertification. Some of them will be pretty long-term, 4 days there. That's still the 30% from the facility for these ones as well. It should be all of them will give me that 30% benefit. So we're going to get into some long-term researching, but it would be, I think it would be 7 days without this stuff. What? Oh god, I hope I set that other one for 10. 10 jobs, okay. Yeah, these should each be about 4 days. I'm not sure what the tractor beam is going to be, though, especially because it's time and not Matt. What do you have to say for yourself? 5 days. That's not bad. It's a lot of money down for research costs. But hey, it goes back into the Alliance, and we've started the process, so now we don't have to worry about wasting time not producing and not researching. Now we get to do the production side of things, which means going over and grabbing some different blueprints in a different trip. And then the fun begins with logistical movements. Now for the fun part of the logistics, I take a look at the jobs I'm going to be doing here. Whoops. Start with the Hornets. We're going to be doing 3-day job runs. Please switch blueprints, game. I would like to switch now, please. And I can just say 3-day-ish, and I can copy that material information here, put it into my notepad blueprint thingamabob. It tells me how many are required. I don't know what that available number is. I shouldn't have any. What does it even mean? I don't know. I hope it's not important. Wait, no, okay. Item available, 0 required. Alright. Ah, estimated unit price. Okay, so the ones I need are the required numbers. Is that right? That seems like a pretty small number, except for the tritanium. I guess that's the point. Okay, so I want to get rid of these numbers, because the estimated unit price is irrelevant to me. I just need to know how many. And I'll do that for each one of these, and then I'll email these off to my HiSec alt, have him pick up the materials, and then truck them around, which should be ever so much fun. Why is that... Why was that 1900 in 1996? I mean, it's a good year, but whatever. I won't mess with it. Okay, just Intel found Kerberos to headgate is green, no bubbles. That means it's my time to go. I've got a badger mushroom here, ready to rock with some Arcanor that I mined earlier and a whole bunch of other materials that I got from hanging out with corp mates and doing a little ratting myself. About 60 mil worth of stuff, so no small potatoes, but totally doable. And I just got completely run over by Brack in his Loki. My leg! So I'm not really worried about this thing's tank or anything like that. I've just got it fitted out with some basic stuff and a couple of turning maneuver thingamabobs. I don't need to get full capacity out of it because my alt doesn't even have the skills to train or to use the maxed capacity iteron yet. So for now, we're just going to keep it simple and try to go fast. But I think the important thing is just keeping an idea on what's going on in the Kerberos to Headgate. I know that in GE right now, there is a group of some harpies camping, CFC harpies camping the GE TAC station, which is sort of like, you know, the sky being blue. It's just always sort of happening. Plump described it as waves crashing over a beach. They'll always be there. You just got to try not to get crushed. You got to learn to be a surfer. Okay, there's only 14 harpies. Yeah, this is a pretty cool thing where people can upload their D-scans of what they're seeing on their little scantily bloopers or whatever. I don't know how to do it, but it's pretty cool. Right now, I don't need to worry because there's nobody fucking here, so... But the difficult part is going to be... I don't even use waypoints for this. I just need to get to GE TAC. Hopefully the bridge won't be bubbled. I can show you guys the bridge, and then that'll put me in head. And if head is safe, then I can go ahead and hop out to HiSec and hope that nobody's on the other side, which is a distinct possibility. Although I'd say because I don't know about what time it is for most of our war targets or whatever, hopefully they will be busy doing other things, like fondling their Tech 12 interceptor capital ships. I don't know, whatever it is that the fuck they do. Okay, so this is where things get a little tricky. Because I know that there's CFC in this sector. They could be moving around at all times between all sorts of weird places to move from fleet to fleet. So I'm going to go to my triangle spot, which is just a random spot in null space. It'd be dead space. It'd be better if I didn't do it on the elliptic of the solar system. Better if you could just go upwards or something like that. But there's not a lot of... That one planet up there is pretty high up. But I imagine a lot of people use that, so I don't know if I want to bother. For now, this one spot in dead space is pretty admirable for changing my trajectory when coming into and out of certain spots. So from here, in the middle of fucking nowhere, we can go to the bridge. Which is going to get us to head GP, assuming it's not... I don't think it'll ever be a problem at the bridge, because... there's a player on the POS there that has a bunch of guns and shit and a bubble, so it's not really beneficial for people to try to camp the bridge. I think people know where it is. It's just a matter of cost-benefit analysis, if you will. Bridges are pretty cool. I dig them. Woo. Yeah. I don't think anybody's really going to want to mess with that, so we're fairly safe. And we'll use the you what bridge to go to head GP. The flaming anus of death. I don't need no damn stargates. I'll just go straight past him. Whoop. All right, so now someone did say that head GP was clear a little bit ago. According to local, there's two grays. I think I might have a... Yeah, I have a triangle spot here as well. Although, this might actually... I did fuck up one of these, and it might actually just be at the sun, which would be unfortunate, because that's a common place for the Poirats to be. I don't think I even need to do this. If I do run into a bubble at the Kebber's Gate, which is the outlet into Highsec, it'll be an ally bubble, and they'll either turn it off for me or let me power through it. I guess that depends on how bored they are. Yeah, this is going to be a weird trajectory. I should have put something over there, maybe. If there is a bubble here, I'll still hit it. I need to remember that this safe spot is not very safe. Abandoned Shaprack. Hello. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that this is just a... Yeah, this is just a sun warp. Oh, well. Who is going to be here? There's almost always someone at the gate. It's just a matter of whether it's blues or grays. Okay, I guess this time there's nothing. Now, when I go through here is where the real fun begins, because this is the output to nullsec and highsec is where a lot of the war target shenanigans go on. Usually this one's pretty untrafficked, but yeah, okay, there's five all newts, nobody right here, at least not uncloaked, but you can see by the presence of Concord people that it is a distinct possibility. No reds, though. This is where the reds come into play. Avoiding them in highsec is a bit problematic. Obviously, we wouldn't have gone all the way through nullsec if we didn't think it was going to be a problem, but now we have even more wars than just the one. We're in war with Sherwood Enterprises, the Marmite Collective, the Clown Shoe Crew, and SOS. These are only relevant in highsec. And it just comes down to whether or not they're bored enough to move all the way out here to Conded to try to fuck with us. And I don't think they are, hopefully. It's a difficult transition, though, from going to, oh god, this is the scariest thing ever, to, oh, it's just a bunch of guys hanging out, doing normal stuff. A couple jumps, and then we can offload and contract that over to Mr. Anonymous and have him do my business for me. Without having to worry about those bastards with their war decks. Awesome. Part one completed. Now we're going to do the whole switchy character-y thingy and contract this crap over. And from there, it should be just a matter of whether or not anybody wants to suicide gank me in high sec, because they're going to have to deal with Concord. Somebody left us a present! It was me on my alt, transporting stuff through high sec. And an extra 30 mil left over after buying those minerals. So a little bit of profit. Now comes the fun part. We gotta go back into nullsec with our load of cargo in our, I was gonna say paper thin, but paper might be too thick. Too tough to describe an iteron. Maybe, I don't know, air in, dead, our dead, our necrotic zombie pre-exploded paper, yeah, paper's fine. The issue that I have is that I'm, in the process of transiting this character through here, I know that there is a person in an Orthrus camping the head GP Kebber's Gate. Orthruses are really cool, and I want one, but I don't want one shooting at me. They're basically tackling cruisers. It's a badass little ship, but yeah, I don't want one pointed at me. Also, I know that there was a roaming gang of around five neutrals in the system in Catch We're Headed To, 3-0, and that's also not good, because I need to get in there and put my minerals in the hole where the stuff comes out. But we're gonna do it anyway, because that's what we do. I tried to wait until a downtime spike, but events conspired, yo. Well, that went well. there was a gate camp at the Three Taco Gate that people didn't have intel on. Oh well.